Hey friends, my name is Marissa and welcome to my channel, The Budgeting Wife, where we talk about all things money and personal finance related. In today's video, I'm sharing with you five free things that you can do this summer. And you may look at the title and think, Marissa, summer's almost over. It's already the middle of July. Back to school is right around the corner. That's true, but you definitely need to enjoy this last month and a half-ish that we have of summer. And so here are five free things that you can still do this summer. Number one is a trip to the beach. And if you don't live on a coastal state, then I understand that this isn't totally possible, but for us in Oregon, going to the beach is definitely a fun and free activity. The only cost is the gas to get out there. You can pack a picnic lunch, hang out on the beach. If you do live in a spot where going to the beach isn't an easy drive, go to the lake, down to the river, pack a lunch. Those are super fun ways to get out and get some sun in the summertime and enjoy a little picnic. Number two is music and movies in the park. These are two things that many cities offer in the summertime at different locations all around the city, of things that residents can go to and just enjoy an evening of free music or a free movie in the park. This is a great thing that you can do to just pack a little picnic dinner again and just take the kids with you, or just a fun little date night as well, and go to your local park and see what kinds of activities that they have in store for you. Number three is hiking. In Oregon, we have a ton of natural beauty and therefore a lot of people go hiking, and it is definitely a free activity for the most part that you can enjoy as long as you go to a place that doesn't charge a fee, like a state park or something like that, to get into to go hiking. So if you're looking for a way to get outside, enjoy some scenic beauty, and have it still work within your budget, going on a hike or even a bike ride is a great option this summer. The fourth free thing that you can do this summer is a backyard games tournament. So whether you're into badminton, bocce ball, croquet, basketball, soccer, so many options, set up a little tournament at your home and invite some friends over. Maybe you'll pay a little bit for the barbecue, but to host a fun evening in your backyard for free is a great way to make some super fun memories this summer for a low price. The fifth thing that you can do this summer for free is going to your local fair or parade. And there are county fairs and state fairs, and those do cost money, but a lot of cities have some small town fairs, which are so fun to go to because of the local enthusiasm for it all. My hometown has a small little fair that they do every year, which is so fun, and they have concerts, they have dancing, the parade goes through on the Saturday, so there's so many different fun activities that you can do, and all of it's free. So this is a great way to bring the kids down to the park and just enjoy the music and the friendships that you have with your hometown. So that is all that I have for you guys today for this video. If you enjoy it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos on personal finance and budgeting. I understand that these free activities have maybe some little bit of a charge to them, but for the most part, you can do them for a low cost or basically free. So I hope that that gives you guys a few ideas that you can use to enjoy the rest of your summer for the next couple months. And with that, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.